the property markets within the Emirates are very different from one another. So there are certainly more than seven different property markets here, and Dubai itself has got some very significantly different subsets within the marketplace. The Dubai market is leading the resurrection of the markets here at the moment, and the central business district of Dubai is very busy in terms of demand and in terms of new people entering the marketplace. So that's positive for the UAE overall. Insofar as Abu Dhabi is concerned, they have a strategic plan to create a business centre around the development which is going on there. It's slightly behind where Dubai is in terms of the development cycle, and we expect quite a lot of stock to be delivered to the marketplace over the next 3 or 4 years. So the demand for accommodation and the availability of accommodation from a commercial perspective in Abu Dhabi is not currently on a par with Dubai. Insofar as the other Emirates are concerned, the Northern Emirates, we're seeing some movement, but not very much. They are dominated by the residential sector, and they created a development plan which would appeal to people wanting second homes. The GCC market has remained relatively strong, but the European and overseas markets, or the further afield markets, they have gone away at the moment. So they will need a recovery in the general global economy before they see an upturn in their property markets. Deutsche Bank's report on the way that values have fallen here is probably pretty accurate. The peak of the market was never sustainable, what had ever happened in the global economy. So there was already an anticipation that there would be a decline in values, whatever happened elsewhere. But it's important to remember that not all prices got to that peak level. So we have some locations where we're sitting at the moment in Omar Square, where some rents that were achieved have not, the market has not come down to those rents. So we're still seeing rental increases at review in respect of some of the properties in some locations within some of the markets within the UAE. I anticipate that the best locations within Dubai will bottom out during the course of this year, and there'll be no further decline in the very best locations for the best buildings, but other locations within the Emirates will continue to decline over the next 12 months or so. The reduction in values here, I think, has had a positive effect on the Dubai market, because it's made Dubai competitive, not just in a regional aspect, but comparatively with other centres with whom it competes globally, Singapore, etc. So placing regional or greater regional locations, HQs, here has made Dubai in particular a much more attractive location to global corporates. The reduction in values has also meant that only the most competitive and the strongest schemes and developers are still active in the marketplace. And people's due diligence and the processes through which they go to either fund schemes, complete schemes, or let schemes has become much more professional. So some of the practice which inevitably develops in any market, which is overblown in terms of value, they have been driven out of the marketplace. So we're going forward, we're likely to see a much more professional marketplace here, which in turn will lead to an increase in values going forward. One of the most difficult concepts for developers to get over is the profit margin which affordable housing has delivered to them over the years. And in the Emirates, historically, that's been a very difficult target to achieve because of the cost of land. If you go to the marketplace and buy a piece of land and put affordable housing on it, it doesn't give you anything like the return historically that it has done over the last recent history. Going forward, because land prices have fallen significantly, possibly one of the worst affected asset classes here, then the margin for developers to provide return in respect of affordable housing becomes attractive again. Also, the concept of how accommodation is created is being looked at very closely at the moment, and some form of prefabrication, which means that housing units can be mass produced and coupled with relatively cheap land, means that the level of interest and the level of encouragement that a government can give to developers is going to increase the stock of affordable housing here and elsewhere within the GCC. But importantly, this is not a Middle Eastern issue, this is a global issue. And the same impact is being felt elsewhere, and governments are struggling to ensure that developers get the maximum return for providing this type of housing unit, their commercial entities. And at the moment, they're risk averse. So we have to make it, governments have to make it attractive to those developers to develop in this sector. The issue with any economy which is dependent on real estate, as ours clearly is, or a major contributor to GDP here, is that we have confidence returned to the marketplace. So the initiatives which the government has taken to honour the debt incurred by some institutions, whether they be sovereign or not, is very important for the future arrival of new investors. And what we're seeing at the moment is that the steps taken between Abu Dhabi and Dubai over the last couple of years has encouraged new investors to come to the marketplace. And the irony we're seeing at the moment is there's quite a lot of money coming into the UAE market, especially the Dubai market at the moment, but they don't have the product in which to invest. So what we need to see is a balance of buyer and seller expectations in terms of value come together, and then we'll see the investors coming back, because the UAE at the moment is looking pretty good value in global way, in a global comparative way. So I think by putting certain things, particularly related to finance, encouraging the banks to provide financing, not just for developers but for investors too here, is going to create a level of encouragement which will encourage more investors to come here, which will have an improvement on values, and therefore it's a self-fulfilling prophecy, as it were. The more people who come here to spend, the greater the number of people who will be looking at that marketplace. And as I say, at the moment, this market compared with some of the Far Eastern or the European markets looks to be very good value. Looking at the way that international corporates go through their decision-making for a new office, we do this. This is more than 50% of our business, bringing people from Asia-Pac or the US or from Europe to come and create new businesses in region. What we do is go through effectively a complicated checklist of advantages that one location may have over the other. And at the moment, the majority of the decision making is targeting Dubai. And Dubai is the number one choice of those corporates for, I think, four key reasons. Firstly, the quality of the infrastructure here. Secondly, importantly, the commitment of the government to make a location infrastructurally sound, so the airport, the airline, the road networks, the metro, the quality of the built environment here, all very important, because you subconsciously presume the government wants to spend money in its own backyard, as it were. The maturity of the market is increasingly important, legal regulations allowing tenants to feel secure when they sign a lease here. But the single most important factor here for Dubai is the quality of its pool of labour. People come here because they can recruit, and Dubai at the moment has a labour pool which is significantly ahead of any of its competitors, certainly within the GCC at the moment. And those four components together make a fairly compelling argument for Dubai, which means that at the moment, in our judgment, Dubai gets 60% of the total international demand.